Hey guys, welcome to another video in our supermarket series. If you haven't already, check out our other videos where we look at getting data from Coles and also data from Woolworths. Today we're looking at Aldi, which is the third largest supermarket retailer here in Australia, if you're not from down under. And yeah, we're going to try pull out all the different data items within the Aldi catalog. So let's get into it. So it's going to be pretty similar to the other scrapers that we've built. Essentially, we need to go into the groceries and get all the different grocery categories. Just to note, yes, the catalog is a print catalog, and we haven't scraped anything in there. We're just scraping purely all the online entries on the Aldi website. So jumping to the code, you can see here I've got the categories listed out here, and they have specific SKUs, I believe they're called, that I've had to manually just input into the code. So what the code is going to do essentially in a programmatic way is go into groceries, and then for each different category, for example, fruit and veg, it's going to go into fruit and veg, and it's going to go into a page like this. And then it's going to initially scrape all of these different fruit and veg items from pages 1 to 6. And as you can see here, and then obviously it's going to do some data cleaning and data handling and things like that in this part of the script. And as you can see here, you can see it's going to grab the first 30, the next 30, the next 30 until it hits page 6 and 7. And then it'll go on to the next category, meat and seafood, grab the 30 there, up until all the pages are done, so on and so forth. And what you will get is a spreadsheet like this. Just let me pull it up very quickly. A nice spreadsheet with all the different, similar to our other scrapers, with all the product info available. Yep, so that script's just finished running, and now what it will produce is this Aldi product info. So as you can see, we've got the different categories, the category key, which we had before that we manually input, the product SKU, so the unique identifier for each different product available at Aldi, the name of the product, obviously, what brand it is, the price per 100, price per unit or 100 kilos, the size, whether it's on sale or it's not on sale, and also the URL slug, which we'll need to run our product scraper. So yes, so now what we need to do is essentially use this script here, and what this script will do is essentially go into each page, and I've got the grapes up here in Aldi. Let me just blow this up. So yep, I've got the, yeah, what it will essentially do is call this API endpoint within each of the Aldi, within the Aldi website itself. And that's gonna give you all this different data related to the product. There's not as much data as the other supermarkets, but nonetheless, the important ones are obviously the price per kilo, the product details, and maybe you'd be interested in the origin. We can also get the image as well. So yeah, essentially that's what this script Aldi scraper py does. Here it cleans and passes the data, and then it writes it into a CSV, and it obviously iterates through all the different products. So the end spreadsheet that you're going to get is the Aldi individual products, as again, we did it by SKU. So you got the SKUs, the name of the product, the different brand of the product, a longer description that was available on the website. So I don't think grapes has it, but some products have longer descriptions. For example, this foil, it'll tell you what the foil is, and the description is generally a bit more of a sort of advertising, or what the seller of the item is trying to say to sell the item. We got the size of the item, the price per meter or kilo or 100 grams, some storage instructions if that's relevant, country of origin, whether it's on sale, obviously the URL slug, which we kind of used, and then some images. And again, we get some ingredients, so that could be interesting for some applications that you might want to build. And that's really it. So a bit less detailed than Woolworths and Coles, but also a bit easier to scrape as well, as there's less products. Only 2,574 products. So a very quick script to run. I believe it may only take about 10 minutes. But yeah, if you're keen to get your hands on this Python script, then just I'm either going to put it on my website at automationwithwilt.com, or I'll link you to my GitHub. But just check out the comments in the comments section below to see where you can get your hands on this pretty easy script that I've managed to build. And if you like content like this, please follow, like, and subscribe to the channel. This is the channel of the Wilt Software Development Agency. And otherwise, thanks for watching. And if you have any comments or questions, comment them down below in the comment section. Thanks, guys. Hey, guys. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you're looking to build custom software, my agency, Wilt Software, can help. We specialize in developing high-quality solutions in 30 days or less at a fraction of the traditional cost. And we achieve this by leveraging cutting-edge AI development frameworks. To learn more or to start your project, please visit my website, wiltsoftware.com, or email me directly at my email, which is sales@wiltsoftware.com. Alternatively, I also have my Calendly link in the comments section and also in the description. Thanks again for your time, and I'll see you in the next video.